Rambitan. Well, there's only two more chances for Indonesia to have men's doubles representatives on semi-finals day. When you consider there was three Indonesians at quarter-final stage, and apart from that, five other nationalities, it would be fairly tough if no Indonesians made it through to semi-final stage. Tough for the home fans, that is. But here are the world number twos. Went up on the world ranking one place to number two on Tuesday, 3 days ago. Incredible year they've had so far. And here the Indonesians, Kusumawardana and Rambitan. Now this will be a first meeting between these two pairs. I was slightly surprised about that, but I guess that because of Rambitan's injury, he badly injured that left knee in this very event a year ago.
Red service, Rambitan service.
So
we'll see the same.
The Indonesian pair have chosen to serve, having won the toss of the coin. So far this year, they're number one on the race to the World Tour Finals. This man, Wang Chan, is actually playing his second Indonesia Open, lost in the first round 4 years ago with Di Xinxiang. He's from Xinjiang province on the east coast of China, just south of Shanghai. And they beat Kevin Lee and Tai Lindman from Canada, who had been promoted from the reserve list in the first round, and then beat Matsui and Takauchi of Japan. Both of their matches, as you saw, in two straight games. So to the Indonesians, and this is Pramudia Kusumawardana. He, like both of his opponents, is 22 years of age, from Sukabumi in West Java. Went up one place on the world ranking to number 25, but because they're making their way back after Rambitan's injury, they're way down on their career high of 11. Yerimir Eric Jakob Rambitan is 23 years of age, from Depo in West Java, part of the Jakarta metropolitan area. So their gold at the Southeast Asian Games beat Aaron Char and Soli Eek. I do beg your pardon. That was at the Asia Championships last year. They beat Ben Lane and Sean Vendy in three games, and then beat Mohamed Hassan and Hendra Setiawan, the former champions, in three games. It was one of the last matches on last night. Jakob Sindberg from Denmark is our umpire for this one, and Jess Ewan from Singapore is the service judge. Yes, their gold medal at the recent Southeast Asian Games took place in Cambodia. The Indonesian pair.
Ladies and gentlemen, and Yang Mai King, China. And on my left, Pamitia Kusumawardana, and Yang Mai King, Yorkshire, Jakob Rambitan, Indonesia. to Vachan, Lovell, play.
So it is the Southeast Asian Games gold medalists and former Asian champions. Kusumawardana and Rambitan in the white shirts nearest to us as we're looking down on the court against Liang Weiqing and Wang Chang. Now, Steen, before we really get into this match, we've got to make mention and talk about the Indonesians' match yesterday against Muhammad Hassan and Kendros Setiawan, the three-time former finalists, former champions, of course, together. Setiawan has been in six finals here, five in men's doubles, one in mixed doubles. It was his 23rd consecutive appearance at the Indonesian Open. And I can't help but wonder whether we will see them at the Indonesian Open again. They intend to keep playing and try and qualify for next year's Olympic Games, but the longevity of Hassan and Setiawan is just astonishing.
We have to remember that they're independent players, so I think if they can maintain their motivation and still qualify, I think we will see them again next year.
Missed it.
2-5.
Well, with this Chinese combination, there's no doubt that Wang Chang is the favoured front court player.
And the service judge, Lord Liang, Malaysia.
When he leaps and he's played from his forehand corner, deep forehand corner, and he then has moved to his deep backhand corner. He seems to take an extra step because he's not totally confident on that left knee. 2 uncharacteristic errors so far in this match.
He's kind of a little bit late on most of his actions here. Made a couple of mistakes on the right-hand side of the court. That's not late, that's very, very strong play.
8-7.
Thank you. getting committed to that backhand defense. Kusumawardana. There's the backhand defense hit on his forehand side and he can't cope with it. Chen Shichu, their coach. 7 minutes.
Pretty game.
Double quick time. Good umpiring.
11-7.
He asked the players to get back to courts. Kusumawardana didn't do so. And the umpire has said, I'm not going to give you a warning again. Well taken.
This one's such a into the second spot on the world ranking. And given Amateur's last couple of tournaments here, you could make an argument that it is perhaps the best men's double in the world that we're watching at the moment.
I think 50% of their tournaments played so far, they've reached the final.
Yeah.
I mean, that's a pretty good argument, isn't it, that they're the best men in the world at the moment. Around their non-racket arm.
Yeah.
That's a little heart monitor, I think. They're not keeping track of lots of scientific data.
Trying to get precise measures of what the workload is.
And the recovery rate, presumably,
yeah,
after a hard rally.
Yeah. For singles, it could also be a watch if you know what heart rate your lactate as it starts to kick in. That could be valuable information. No, bicyclists never practice or compete without a heart monitor.
16, 12.
Defensive stance.
Service over 17-13.
Not many long rallies, have we? And I wonder what the longest rally is.
Service forward.
You're not in the best position to see, but that looked quite low to me.
Definitely one of the most powerful smashes in the men's doubles discipline, and really hard to control when it hits with the drift. 20. The line has been really, really short. It's sort of like when Sukumuru and Gideon were at their best. Super short games.
16, 20.
Even a window.
Some one game point has come and gone. Convert on their second. 21-16, opening game. Well, quite astonishing that they're only seeded six when they are currently the world number two ranked player. But that's because their ranking was much lower when the entries went into this tournament. So 21-16 in 14 minutes, the opening game. To Liang Weiqing and Wang Chang. So one game to to the good. The new world number two is Liang Weiqing and Wang Chang against the flowing hair of Kusumawardana and Rambitan. Steve, just at the end of that opening game, you know, I was alluding to the fact that the Chinese pair are only seeded six, and you know, here they are as the world number two pair now. You and I have been an advocate for draws and seedings being done much nearer to the tournament.
Because
it's confusing for the fans. It's how they only seeded six.
It's confusing, and it's also not right the way I see it, because you get a delay before the world ranking actually kicks in. And that delay is not equal because the tournaments are not spread evenly out over the years. So there can be advantages and disadvantages, but the ranking is used to determine so many things in terms of qualification. So I think it needs a review.
About the world ranking. I think it works reasonably well. I think that we need to just have the seeding of the draw done much nearer to the event,
doesn't work with the delay.
Yeah, exactly. Well played. They're really exposing the lack of mobility in the Rambitan.
Is that correct?
That is correct. Error on the low serve. That's his second.
Service situation. Oi. He's a more powerful smasher. Rambitan. And then in the attacking situation, they would need to play. That's great play. We need to play with patience, and I would have Liang Weiqing as my target, so to speak, in the situations where I'm not in a really good position, because he doesn't play as creative as Wang Chang. But then if in a really good position, then I think there's possibilities of actually putting it away on Wang Chang.
To change his racket. And Wang Chang single-handedly wins the rally. It wasn't a broken string, it was a broken racket. Clash of rackets. And Liang Weiqing, the racket was just smashed to smithereens.
Six.
He needs to be a little bit extra ready. The shuttle arrives a split second faster on the Chinese side at the moment. But apart from that, I think he weathered the attack from Kusumawardana brilliantly.
Service over. 7-0.
We're still having these extremely short rallies, aren't we?
Yeah.
Service over.
I like the idea from Rambitan trying to keep it at the net. Playing back at Liang. He can't move out there around the turn. He's relying on Kusumawardana working really, really hard from the backcourt. Cheering that's going on.
10-8.
Biting. Matches on court number one so far today that have involved Indonesian players, and all Indonesian players have lost so far. It's not been a good day for Indonesia on court one. Home fans desperate for something to cheer here.
Rabbit's gone.
See, that movement.
Yeah.
He can't land them that roughly.
No, it's a dire situation for Indonesian men's double with Mark Gillian also out with injury.
To see it.
Has
to take an extra step. Suka Ginting beat Jonathan Christie, so there's at least one home interest tomorrow.
Super interceptions there.
Yeah, well, Rambitan is really struggling movement wise. I think he's struggling stamina-wise as well. Yeah, look at the Indonesians. Bent double.
14, 15. Nope. 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 Play. and we are going to have another one. So it is. Play on. 14, 15.
Longest rally so far, 57 shots. And the umpire's quite right. Just because there's been a long rally doesn't mean to say you can either have a towel down and a drink.
No,
play will be continuous. The physicality of the sport is supposed to be a major part of the test of badminton.
Playing one rally and then I can towel down.
That was a tired looking shot. No elevation off the floor at all. Smash with a bent arm. Kusumawardana and Rambitan, and 3 points quick away from forcing the third and deciding game.
Thank you.
Away from taking the second game and forcing the decider.
I think
19-15.
Young Wekong has fallen out of the match again.
Service over. 16.
Bounce back.
19.
The hard hitting Chinese.
Well,
the second game.
And Yeremiah Rambitan, 21-17. One game all.
37 minutes into the match, and it's one game all. And well fought by the Indonesians, Kusumawardana and Rambitan. So here we go, third and deciding game. Kusumawardana and the Rambitan of Indonesia. Nearest to us against the new world number twos. Well, to me, not only did you identify that Liang Weikang went off his game a little bit, Steve, but they seem to go a little bit defensive, the Chinese pair.
Sorry, I can't believe what you're saying. There's so much cheering going on.
Had a flick serve that's not been called the fault. Yeah, I'm struggling to see how that's any higher than the low serves that he's been playing. But I'm not in the best position to see the service judges.
No chance.
Is that to me the Chinese pair went a bit defensive.
Yes.
In that second game.
A lot. And I think Kusumawardana has raised his game a lot, both his work rate and his quality in his shots. He's having to do an awful lot of work given the limitations of Rambitan's movement.
Okay.
pointing on the more difficult side of the poles, not lifting too much to Liang Weikong, who gets help. But on the other hand, not playing it into the hands of his partner either. I think they should challenge him at the net in the service situation as we see it now. That it's both hard and steep, and it's much more easy for Wang Chang to get involved in the next one.
Well, this is four straight points. Indonesians need to stop this run. Another gift in it. Fourth service error from the Atway pen. And he doesn't really have the option of flicking. Virtually every flick serve has been called a fault. Kusumawardana more than held the fort. Disagreement as to whether the shuttle should be changed or not. Good flick.
That was the first one that has been let through.
Yeah, they didn't get called a fault. Yeah, well played. And so high, you might as well just have given it a bit of a thump. Nine all. Very, very good work from Wang Chang.
stays in.
Yeah. So it's a two-point advantage to the current world number twos as they change ends in this deciding game. Well, both pairs have played better from the far side of the court, which is where the Indonesians will be finishing the match.
They had an 11-8 lead at the interval in the second game. Now they're down 9-11, so it bodes for a thriller. Play. So many strings in his racket that he had to give two rackets and two grips to the referee, Lynn Nixie, and she had to go find an Indonesian official who could re-grip two rackets for him.
Good work from Liang Wei King. Dick is being called again. We saw that in our last match, didn't we? And it's been a run of points, four straight points to be precise, for the Chinese pair. So this medical timeout will just break the rhythm. Rambitan also took the opportunity to reapply his knee support.
Wang Chang is taking a towel over his head, so he's sort of taking a break from the world.
Yeah. Dino Djokovic, he sometimes does that, doesn't he?
The referee has brought two more rackets back to Rambitan now.
So a run of four straight points, and that run continue for the Chinese pair. One of the Indonesians battle back. No, it continues. tested.
Yeah. I think they might win this challenge.
Here we go. And they have won the challenge. Very good challenge. This is a huge point. And at this crucial, crucial stage, the Indonesians into the lead. And it's match point opportunities. Indonesians on the verge of victory in this quarter-final. One match point well saved with a good return of serve from Wang Chan. But it is Liang Weikeng who's serving. He's made 5 service errors so far in the match, and he's been faulted as well for an illegal serve. Kusumawardana and the Rambitan come back to take this deciding game. 10 of the last 12 points and 21-19 in the deciding game. Exactly 1 hour and a thrilling, quite frankly, at 11-17 down, an unlikely victory for Pramudia Kusumawardana and Yeremia Rambitan. Well, Indonesia will have 2 involvements on semi-final Saturday tomorrow. Men's singles and men's doubles. Their confirmation of how they did it, 16-21, 21-17, 21-19 in the deciding game from an 11-17 deficit. Quite extraordinary. Well, what a day it's been, and it all started at noon today here on quarterfinals day with the mixed doubles pair from Hong Kong, China, Tang and Si, the two left-handers. Had match points in the second game, but they were sent to the decider against Tarbalin and Peek from the Netherlands, 21-18 in the deciding game. Then the defending champion in the women's singles, Tai Su Ying, she's also been 3-time champion, was beaten by the former world and Olympic champion, Carolina Marin, who turned 30 yesterday. She really played extremely well today, the left-hander from Spain. Then it was mixed doubles and Watanabe and Higashino, 2 straight games against Rivaldi and Mentari. Then it was women's singles and the Olympic champion Chen Ufei beat Kim Ga-un of Korea. That was also 2 straight games. Then we had an excellent men's singles with the former world number one and winner here in 2017, Kidambi, putting up a brave fight against the All England champion Li Shifeng, but the Chinese player coming through in an hour and 9 minutes. Then it was men's doubles and the reigning Asian champions, Ranking Reddy and Shetty, beat the world number ones, Alfian and Ardianto, in two comfortable games, 13 and 13. We then had a women's doubles with exactly the same scoreline. Fukushima and Hirota, the two-time former champions here at the Indonesian Open, beat the Olympic champion Rahayu with her new partner Ramadanti. Then it was men's singles, and Victor Axelsen, the two-time defending champion, was in a battle against another former champion, Chu Tianchen of Chinese Taipei, who'd won this title 4 years ago. Axelsen winning on his fifth match point opportunity in that second game, having really been outstanding in the opening game. Then it was men's doubles, and the reigning world champions Aaron Char and Solwyn Eek beat Koga and Saito in two straight games. And as we've just witnessed in the last quarterfinal of the day, Kusumawardana and Rambitan coming back against Liang Weikeng and Wang Chang, the new world number twos, from an 11-7 deficit in the deciding game. 10 of the last 12 points to book their place in the semi-finals tomorrow. All 10 semi-finals tomorrow here on court number one. It'll be the same time as today, 12 noon local time. That's 0500 GMT. From all of us here, and especially from Steve Peterson and myself, Jill Clark, we'll see you tomorrow. Bye for now.